Shalom, Israel. Most High in Christ. Bless. This is Captain Isaac here from IUIC Dallas Congregation. This video that you're about to see is of Mark Reiser, the Edomite, who decided to drop by our camp last week. This man is obsessed with Israel. He's completely obsessed with Israel. He's losing sleep at the fact that Christ is a black man and he only died for the nation of Israel, which be the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and natives, who are the 12 tribes of Israel. And there's no salvation for none of the other nations. When Christ comes back, the nations are going to be servants and slaves, plain and simple. If the Bible taught that all nations were equal, we would teach that. If the Bible taught that we all be holding hands in the kingdom of heaven, singing kumbaya, we would teach that. But fortunately for us, it doesn't. And unfortunately for him, it doesn't either. So we're going to watch this video, and I'm going to show you guys how this man had the audacity to come up to the camp, the congregation, the school, stand outside and record right in front of our doorsteps. And many of the women and the kids were afraid for their lives. They were scared because this is a man that's clearly an anti-Semite. He's racist. He hates the idea of a black Christ. He hates the idea of so-called Negroes being the Israelites. And many of the women and kids stayed inside because they were in fear, because this is a man that teaches anti-Semitism. Okay, he hates black people, plain and simple. You have many Jewish synagogues in Dallas. You have many Jewish synagogues in Dallas. And I think I got the stats right here. Let me look it up. You have 22 synagogues in the Dallas region. And according to the Jewish Talmud, they teach that the goyim is cattle, right? The other nations. And the nations are going to go into slavery. There's no salvation for them when their Messiah returns. This is according to Jewish texts. But you'll never see Mark Reiser, the Edomite, go before any of their synagogues, try to get them on film, nor does he ever step foot into a synagogue and try to debate none of their rabbis. Okay, you have Catholic churches out here in Dallas. You have 298 Catholic churches and 4,392 Catholic priests that have been accused of molesting young boys in Dallas. You'll never see Mark Reiser go to any Catholic church and do what he's doing to us, all right, to many Israelite camps. I believe he went before GMS, and he also went to One Body of Yahawashah. Now he wants to come to IUIC. He's obsessed with Israel. He's losing sleep at night. Okay, so let's roll the tape. Let's roll the tape, please. All right, let's play it.
Shalom, sir. Most High Christ bless you, all right?
I don't know.
We're not going to engage this. We're going to go over there and just record him.
Right.
Stand there and record.
So as you see, this man has nothing better to do. He's about to pop out.
He took off.
Behind the car. He's seen us coming.
How y'all doing? I would come talk to you guys, but you guys will never talk to me. So
the reason we don't talk to you is because there's nothing to talk about. The Bible's plain. Like I said before, if the Bible taught all nations could be saved, we would teach that. There's nothing to talk about. You can try to email the bishop, and when he has time, because the bishop is an extremely busy man, when he has time to play and he decides to get back to you, he might. You can try to email him, but right now we got work to do. We're resurrecting the nation of Israel. We're traveling, setting up different camps and congregations, all right, getting our people to repent. We don't have time to deal with the nations. We don't have time to play around, okay, especially with you heathens. Come on.
I would come talk to you guys, but you guys will never talk to me, so I just had to make videos in front of the school instead. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. They're recording us.
I know. I'm trying to turn it on.
The verse that I've been looking at is in Acts 26. That's the passage I was looking at in front of your school. I'd much rather engage you. Of course, I wouldn't come up when the children are there. I wouldn't do that. But I would talk to the men. And the verse would be this. I could ask you what I just asked the camera. It's Acts 26, verse 29. Do you guys remember when Paul was standing before Agrippa? And remember, he was on trial before Agrippa. Now, do you guys know who Agrippa's descendants or his ancestors were? Do you know who Agrippa's ancestors were?
We just listen.
Agrippa's ancestors were of Idumea. And you know what it means in Greek, somebody's ancestors were from Idumea, right? It means, under the old language, they were Edomites. Now, you guys have a 12 tribes chart that you've inherited from Bivens and Ariyah. And on that 12 tribes chart, you have nations that you think are Israel. Then you have another thing called the 18 nations breakdown, which is right on the IUIC website, Israel Unite. And on there, you have nations you believe are essentially non-elect nations. These are ethnic groups of people who cannot be saved. Now, you guys believe that the Edomites are one of the group nations or groups of people that cannot be saved, right? And in fact, you teach that in the kingdom, they'll be your servants, they'll be your slaves. Here's the question, though. Does Paul agree with your belief? If he doesn't, you got to ask yourself, why aren't my beliefs apostolic? So let me just read you this key part right here. Acts 26, verse 28. Agrippa, who's an Edomite, said to Paul, "Are you going to persuade me to become a Christian so easily?" That's what he says to him. Now look what Paul says. "I wish before God," replied Paul, "that whether easily or with difficulty, not only you," so that's an affirmative. Is it saying in the military? That's an affirmative. He said, "Do you want me to become a Christian?" Paul says, "I wish before God." That's a way to say, "I pray to God about this." So that's an affirmative. Then he double affirmatives. Makes a double affirmative when he says this. Whether easily or with difficulty, not only you, but all who listen to me today might become as I am. Now here's what's so crazy about that. If he just said you, you might be able to, okay, find some way out of it. Maybe, I still don't think you could, because the grip is clearly of Idumea. But he says, all who hear me today. Now, you gentlemen know that everybody in that room with Agrippa, especially considering we know Festus is in the room, those are not all Jews. Those are not all Israelites. Those are not Hebrew men and women. Why does he say, "I would have you all to become a Christian like I am"? And here's the kicker. Not only you, but all who listen to me today might become as I am, except for these chains. So here's a question. If you believe the Edomites, of whom Agrippa was one of, are going to be your servants in the kingdom for all eternity, or actually for the 1,000 years until they get vanquished, if you think they're going to be your servants and in chains, why did Paul say he prays to God that Agrippa won't be in chains? You have to answer that question. Because it looks to me like we have one verse, and there's a lot more verses we could go to, but we got one verse right here that single-handedly deconstructs Hebrew Israelism. It single-handedly destroys your soteriology. It single-handedly discombobulates your eschatology. It single-handedly does away with it. So the question is, when you guys go out and you're downtown, you're around Maine or wherever you want to stand in Dallas, when you see someone you perceive to be an Edomite, even though you're certainly, certainly mistaken about their identity, when you see them, will you say, "Hey, you of Idumea, just like Paul said to Agrippa, I wish before God you could become just like me, except don't have chains on"? Because you believe you're still in your captivity. And so you could say to them, "I wish you could be just like I am right now, except I pray before God that you won't be in captivity." Could you men say that? If the answer to that question is no, my question would be, why? Why can't you say that? Why wouldn't you be able to say to the one you think is an Edomite, "I would like you to be like me, except for these chains"? Why not? Any of you guys have answers? Now I have a question. Who are you obeying right now? What I mean by that is this. If you can't speak with me, and I'm asking you to give a defense for your beliefs, are you getting both of this? I mean, they're getting me. I'd like to make sure I got both of them, since they're getting me. If you can't speak to me or out and give a defense for your beliefs, are you obeying Nathaniel and Ithan, Yahwasup, or are you obeying Jesus Christ? Can I show you a verse that shows you're not obeying Jesus Christ by not giving an answer?
Now he's going to go to Acts 26, where it talks about Agrippa. Let's read that real quick. Yes.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 26 and verse 1. Then Agrippa said unto Paul, thou art permitted to speak for thyself. Then Paul stretched forth the hand and answered.
Agrippa, if you know the background, he is an Idumean, all right, from the land of Antipater, okay? Come on. He's an Idumean, meaning he's an Edomite, all right? He's Esau. He's an Edomite. Go ahead.
And answered for himself, I think myself happy, King Agrippa, because I shall answer for myself this day before thee, touching all the things whereof I am accused of the Jews, especially because I know thee to be an expert in all customs and questions which are among the Jews. Wherefore, I beseech thee to hear me patiently. My manner of life from my youth, which was at the first among mine own nation at Jerusalem, know all the Jews, which I knew me from the beginning, if they would testify that after the most straitest sect of our religion, I lived a Pharisee. Verse 6, and now I stand and am judged for the hope of the promise made of God unto our fathers, unto which promise our 12 tribes instantly serving God day and night.
You hear what it says? It says our 12 tribes. The key is right there. The Bible's redundant. It's always been about the Israelites. For the Israelites, by the Israelites, to the Israelites. Our 12 tribes. Okay? Come on.
Instantly serving God day and night. Hope to come. For which hope's sake, King Agrippa, I am accused of the Jews. Why should it be thought a thing incredible with you that God should raise the dead? I verily thought with myself that I ought to do many things contrary to the name of Jesus of Nazareth, which thing I also did in Jerusalem, and many of the saints did I shut up in prison.
So Paul is giving a background of when he was Saul, okay? And he also speaks about his conversion to Christ. Jump to verse 27.
Verse 27. Then Agrippa said unto Paul, almost thou persuadest me to be a Christian.
So Agrippa said, remember, Agrippa was Agrippa the Herod, right, was an Idumean. They were raised in the customs of the Jews. Remember during the time of John Hyrcanus when the whole sect of Idumea and the Jews became one. They were inseparable. Why? Because they were converted. They were converted to our customs. So Agrippa was well familiar with the customs of the Israelites, okay? But he was still a heathen. Come on.
Verse 29.
Because of Paul's testimony, he said, you almost persuaded me to be a Jew. Come on.
And Paul said, I would to God that not only thou, but also all that hear me this day.
Where so Paul is before Agrippa, before Festus, okay? Who are heathens, but who are what? In a power seat, in a seat of rulership. So now it's a matter of life and death, right? So Vocab, he takes this verse and he says, well, you know, why would he say that? That means there's salvation. No, Vocab. No, Mark Reiser. There's no salvation for the Israelites. Paul was using wisdom. Paul was using wisdom in his speech. Get me Matthew 10 real quick. Get me Matthew 10. And I want you to start at verse 18. Well, Paul was using wisdom. Paul is not going to sit before Agrippa and call him the devil that the Bible speaks of. He's not going to say, you're an Edomite and there's no salvation for you. When his life is on the line, he still had work to do. He still had work to do. Okay, we're in the book of Acts. So if Paul would have got put to death right there, there would be no book of Romans. There would be no letter to the church in Corinth and so forth. He had work to do. He was using wisdom. The same way if we go to court today, I'm not going to tell the judge, you're an Edomite and you're going into slavery. He's like, what? Right in the courtroom? Of course not. Come on.
The book of Matthew, chapter 10 and verse 18. And he shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles.
Come on.
But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak.
Come on.
For it shall be given you in the same hour what ye shall speak.
So the Spirit of Christ was in Paul, and he had enough wisdom, he had enough knowledge to use the proper wisdom on how to get out of that situation. Not to agree with the adversaries quickly. To what? Flatter him. Sure. There's no salvation for Esau. Get me Revelation 2, verse 26. Now we're going to go to the last testament, the last book of the Bible in the New Testament. And I'm going to show you that out of Christ's own mouth, Christ's own words. Come on.
Revelation chapter 2 and verse 26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works.
The he is making reference to the Israelites, Mark Reiser. The he here is making reference to the Israelites. The overcometh is overcometh your own personal trials and tribulations and sin. He that overcometh, come on.
And keepeth my works unto the end. To him will I give power over the nations.
Now, if we're all going to be equal, if we're all going to be equal in the kingdom of heaven, why does it say that Christ is going to give the Israelites power over the nation? Did it say beneath the nations?
Over the nations.
Equal to the nations?
Over the nations.
And what are we going to do with this power?
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron.
So if we're all going to be in the kingdom of heaven as equals, Mark Reiser, why are we going to rule them with a rod of iron? Read it again.
And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers.
Even as a vessel of potter, they shall be broken to shivers. Come on.
Even as I received of my Father.
Even as I received of my Father. Give me Revelation 13, verse 10. And I don't want to hear that was for that time, because that didn't happen yet. Christ said, overcome to the end. Overcome to the end. Revelation 13, verse 10.
Revelation chapter 13 and verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
Be killed with the sword. Come on.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. Who are the saints? The Israelites. Who are the Israelites? The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and native Indians. That's us. That's who we be. Now, show me the other video, please. So this is intimidation tactics that Mark Reiser has been using against IUIC. Okay. Come on. Press play.
Verse 82.
Here he is.
Strongest
dressed
among men in enmity to the believers, wilt thou find the Jews and pagans. He says, Surah 98, verse 6. That Jews and Christians are the worst of creatures, along with the pagans. And so, as Muslims, we must confront the Jews. And after searching, we have found the true Israelites. They
stand. So this is straight anti-Semitism. And this is intimidation tactics. This is intimidation tactics, all right, that he's using. All right, jump to the camp.
Your evidence! You are Israel! Are you Israel because your shirt says it? I have a shirt that says Arizona Cardinals. Am I a Cardinal?
What was he?
White.
What was the prophet?
White.
So the white prophet had black slaves?
That's right. These men are afraid to answer. They will not answer because they do not have the Quran. They do not have the Hadith. The garments. Are cargo pants part of the garments? Are cargo pants in the Bible? Is JCPenney in the Bible? Are black boots garments in the Bible? Are purple and gold button-up shirts in the Bible? No, they are not. What garments are you talking about?
What you have here is a desperate Edomite that's losing his mind. Never thought to go into the Jewish synagogues or any Catholic churches, but he wants to come to us. You know why? Because we have the truth. He knows exactly what the Bible is speaking about, and he sees it manifesting before his eyes. He sees the resurrection of the Israelites, and he's losing sleep over it. He's losing his mind. He is losing his mind. Get me this last scripture.
The book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 2 and verse 16. To the one we are the savior of death unto death.
So to the one, we are the savior of death unto death. That's talking about these heathens. They see the outcome, they read the Bible, and they see what's going on. They see the manifestation of the book of Ezekiel as far as the valley of bones coming to pass, brothers waking up, sisters waking up, the nation coming back together. So we are a savior of death unto them. Come on.
And to the other, the savior of life unto life.
To those brothers and sisters who want to repent, keep God's commandments in the faith of Christ, we're a savior of life unto life. Okay? So we're going to end it on that. Mr. Mark Reiser, stop harassing the Israelites. It is what it is. We can't add or take anything away from the scriptures. All right? And just go have fun, man. Enjoy the little time that you have left. Go to take your wife out to Disneyland. Take her out to eat. Go have fun, man. Stop harassing us and following us everywhere we go. We ain't going to change the Bible. It is what it is. You're going into slavery and that's it. Shalom.
Hey! Got to pay back. Revenge.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.